morning, friends. In last class, I discussed about sexual determination and how the genes are inherited from parents to offspring. That we have discussed. Now we are going to discuss another important concept, is evolution. So first, let me know what is evolution. So evolution is nothing but continuous changes that brings in increasing adaptability or complexity and the functional efficiency of various species is called as evolution. Or we can say simple, the changes that are going to be occur for several generations of species. That is also we can consider as evolution. So what is evolution means? The continuous changes. Increase adaptability, complexity of organism and functional efficiency of various species. So what it is called as evolution, and this we can simply call as the continuous changes that is occurring for several generation in a species and which is carried out by means of nature. So that is also we can call as a evolution. So the word evolution was first given by Spencer. So who is the scientist? Is Spencer. And the word evolution, which is also called as organic evolution, and the evolution also called as organic evolution, and which is named by Charles Darwin. So in this way we can see that evolution, Darwin, and evolutionary biology. Evolutionary biology is the branch of science that helps in study of the evolutionary changes that is occurring, that is origin of life from pre-existing. So from pre-existing, the origin of life, that can be studied under separate branch of science, and which is called as evolutionary biology. That is evolution and its branch. Now, what is evolution is here? Evolution is nothing but the changes, sequential changes that is occurring from one species to the other species, from one generation to the another generation, from simplest to the complexity according to that condition, the organism which is able to survive. So, for this explanation of evolution, that is, origin of life, was explained by in various scientists in different theories. So, what are the theories or proposal? So, the theories like the special creation, that is one theory. Next, spontaneous creation, that is another theory. Cosmogonic is another theory. And biogenesis is another theory. And chemical origin of life, like these. So, different scientists have proposed different theories to explain the origin of life. So, out of these five theories of origin of life, what are that? Number one, special creation, that is the one, spontaneous creation, next, cosmogonic theory, next, biogenesis, this is another theory, and another theory is chemical origin of life. These are the various theories which were proposed by different scientists. But out of these all five theories, so the chemical origin of life
theory was widely accepted, and he explained that how that organisms are evolved or formed from the simplest to complexity, that is explained in Chemical Origin of Life, and which was proposed by Operian Holden. So who proposed that theory? Operian Holden. So this is the Chemical Origin of Life. So under Chemical Origin of Life theory, what are the explanation given? So Chemical Origin of Life, Chemical Origin, Chemical Origin of, so under that, so Holden explained that the chemical, under Chemical Origin of Life, in three phases he explained the origin of life. So first he explained that formation of simplest inorganic, simplest inorganic substances, that is the one. And next, formation of complex organic substance, next, formation of causative
formation occurred. So later on,
these all together, all these simplest inorganic substance, they all are gathered together, they are associated, aggregate together and formed as some of the complex organic substances like sugar. Sugar substances are formed, and also you can see that amino acids are also formed, and also you can see that fats and glycerol, all the substances are formed as organic substances. This is the way in which all the simplest inorganic substances all together and form as complex organic substances, and like sugars, amino acids, fats and glycerol. In this way we can see that they all are together and form as complex organic substance. And for this formation of this complexity, energy also required. And this energy is provided same light of the thunders, and also you can see that UV radiation from the sun. This helps in the formation of organic substances. That is what we can see. Next, after formation of these complex substances, they all are together. They are associated or aggregate to form colloidal particle. So what is slimy in nature? That is slippery in nature. That is colloid objects are formed. That is colloid objects which are formed by the association or by aggregation of all the complex organic substance. And formed substance is called as microsphere or coserative. So what it is called? Coserative substance. So what it is formed is coserative substance, and which is also called as microsphere. What it is called? Microsphere is formed. So and which is also called as coserative. So these microsphere or coserative, they consist of enzymes. That is, chemical substances are formed. So these enzymes that are helps in synthesis of various substances like nucleic acids and polysaccharides, which are all together associated and formed as a life. Origin is occurred. So all these enzymes which are found in the microsphere, they allowed in the formation or synthesis of various substances like sugars to polysugars, like polysaccharides. All amino acids, they are formed into peptides and proteins. All fatty acids and glycerol all together and formed as fats, and that all together formed as cytoplasm, which is in turn bounded by membrane of lipid protein substance, which is called as plasma membrane, and which we can see that early origin species is prokaryotes, and which is occurred in water bodies. So because of these all the elements and other substances which are found in the water, they all are also playing a key role in the formation of the life on the earth. In this way, we can see that so these enzymes help in the formation of various nucleic acids. As we know that these nucleic acids are found in DNA, that is the DNA and RNA are called as nucleic acids. So these nucleic acids are the substances that are controlling the functioning of the cell. So if the cell functioning is started, they start production of cytoplasm, and they arrange one boundary, as we know that a protective layer which is made up of lipids and proteins, that is called as plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is formed around them, and which is made up of lipid and protein. So finally it is formed as prokaryote. What it is formed? Prokaryote. So early species, early formed species, what is it is? Prokaryotes. In this way we can see that the origin of life, which is occurred by means of simplest to the complex, these prokaryotes. they start developing various changes for several generations from prokaryotes to it start formation of eukaryotic organisms. In this way, you can see that from simplicity to complexity of organelles or organism formation is occurred by various factors which are helped in the formation of new species. That is, we can call as chemical origin of life, which was experimentally proved by Miller. Miller and another his associates, Miller experiment. Under that, he conducted his experiment under artificial condition in a vacuum tube by taking water and supplying the minerals like hydrogen, carbon, methane, these are which are supplied. And later on, what is happened? The formation of methane gas is occurred, and which is in turn helps the formation of amino acids. These all amino acids together associated to form proteins. Proteins are formed into tissues, tissues to form as organs, organ to organ system, and finally organism. In this way, the Miller was proved experimentally the chemical origin of life theory, which was proposed by Popperian. In this way, we can see that another important concept is evolution of organism on the earth.